Alright YouTube, in this video what we are going to see is how to create a Flipkart product showcase. As you can see on the screen, there are three images, or you can see the three thumbnails on the left side, whereas a big image on the right side. If I click either one, you'll see the image changes. I'm literally clicking it, but usually what happens is when I click on a link, it will open in a new tab. So if I click on second link, it will open in a new tab. If I click on third link, you will open the image will open in a new tab. To prevent this, you need to include a function called prevent default. In this video, we are going to see how to use prevent default function so that it can prevent the actual flow of the HTML element. Fine, you will get the source code in the description. Follow all. HTML first, let me remove all the CSS and all the Java jQuery. This is what it looks like, the CSS. This is the plain HTML. Fine, let me show you the HTML. We have a UL which acts as a container for all the LIs, and each LI has an anchor tag, and each anchor tag has an image. Please note the href of the anchor tag and the image source are same. I'm repeating it again, the href of the anchor tag and the src of the images are same. So this is without the function which I have said right now. If I click on the image, it will open. So that means the anchor tag has image inside it, that's why we are able to click on it. So the cursor changes into a point. Fine, now it's time for the CSS. First of all, we need to remove the back default behavior of browser just by setting margin 0 pixel and left of 0 pixel. Fine, now it's time for the UL. What we need to do is we need to float the UL and the container, and I forgot to mention this. This is the container which holds the image on the right side. So I can see, so you can see there I have temporarily added an image called image 2. Fine, now this image has a class image box. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to float UL on one side and the div on the other side. So float left, and now it's time for the image. So image box img box. So it will not show up for now because the image is too large. To shrink the image, I'm going to give the height and width to the list item. The height of, let's say, 100 pixel and width of 100 pixel, so we get a perfect square. Now it's time for the image inside the li. If we give width 100%, it will take the parent width and height. In this case, the parent is li, so we have specified the height and width for li. So indirectly we are giving 100% to image, that is the child. It gets the parent height and width, and now as I said we got it. And as I mentioned, the div is on the left side. Let's give the height and width to the class image box, which is the div, which is the parent of the image. So let me give the height as 300 pixel and the width as 300 pixel. The same way, I'm going to choose the child and give the width 100%. So it takes the height and width of the parent image box. And fine, now to float the element on the center, we need to use the trick which we are using it for almost a week, which is position absolute top of 50% left of 50% transform translate 50% minus 50% on an x-axis minus 50% on y-axis. So it will center, it will be on the center. So in order to remove the bullet style, you are required to add the list style none to the UL. By default, the margin and padding can be removed by specifying the margin 0 and padding 0. This is the default behavior of browser. We cannot do anything. Fine, now we got it. Let me add some border to it for the li. Border 1 pixel solid, and the color is RGBA because I need a black with opacity. 0 is the absence of red, 0 is the absence of green, 0 is the absence of blue, and with opacity 0.1 or let's say 2. So we got the opacity. If you want, you can make it 2 pixel. Now it's time for the image which is in the image box, and fine, let's give the border to the parent, not the child. Fine, that's done. Now if I click it, it will open in a full screen. We don't want this. In order to stop, what you will do is you will write a jQuery document dot ready function let's check by alert. If the document looks, it will display AA. That works fine. That means our jQuery is working. Now it's time for the prevent default function. Choose the anchor tag, or the anchor tag is inside li dot click. If I click on it, I want to prevent its default behavior just by adding prevent default. Whenever there's a click function or any event, the browser passes the event over the argument of the function. So this event can be retrieved with the help of e dot. The browser passes over the e, and this e can be accessed with the help of e dot. So if I click on it, it will not open in a new tab. I'm literally clicking it, but it is not opening up. This is because of the prevent default function. Now what I'm going to do is, if I click on it, the anchor tags href should be converted to the src of this image. Let me repeat. If I click on this image has a anchor tag. This anchor tag has a href tag, and this href tag should get converted to this image's src. So simply href anchor tags href should get converted to image's src. This is what we are going to do in this jQuery function. Fine. I'm going to use it on the on click. When I click on it, that means I want to get the src of the anchor tag. How I'm going to get it? With the help of $this.attribute. Which attribute? The href attribute. I'm going to get the href attribute, and let me alert it so that you can understand what I am saying. So when I click on it, you will get the href. You can see images slash href. If I click on second image, 2.jpg, and if I click on 3.jpg. So this value, I'm going to set it to the src of the class img box. So $choose a parent img box, and on where we are going to change the src, it's the image tag. So I'm going to choose it dot etc attribute. We can set or we can get. In this case we are going to set it. So what we are going to set, we are going to set the href, and what we are going to set, which is the value which we have retrieved. Fine, let me check the sheet. Not working, say we have some mistakes over it. Let me check what it is. Instead of making 2-3 lines, what I'll do is I'll write it in a single line. Start over it. I think we have missed the okay, we'll do the same. Just copy the value and paste it in place of the variable. It is a class and it is working as we expected. Thank you for listening. You will get the source code in the description.